फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस स्ट्रैटेजिक सेशन ऑल ऑफ यू. सो दिस विल बी अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन वेयर आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स लाइक हाउ टू स्कोर अ गुड रैंक इन योर FMG एग्जाम. सो लेट मी जस्ट चेक इफ आई एम ऑनलाइन येट. आई थिंक आई एम ऑनलाइन राइट नाउ. सो अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन फॉर एवरीवन. Okay, so I think I'm online right now. So welcome everyone in this amazing session, strategic session of for your preparation, how to score a good rank in your FMG exam. So first of all, introducing myself, I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on an academy. I've myself scored All India Rank 261 and I have a teaching experience of more than 6 years right now. Now, you are on the best online platform, that is an academy, and I'm a part of this an academy family. Today I will tell you how to score 150 plus in your FMG exam, or how to score a good rank in your FMG, which is very, very important. So let us start with the today's session. First of all, what you all have to do and what you all have to avoid doing while you are preparing for your FMG exam. So right now you have, I think, less than a month left for your December FMG exam. And I know that everybody are preparing for, or they are giving their best to crack this FMG exam. Now, there are many points which I have seen students doing which actually waste their time, and I don't want anybody to repeat that. First of all, I've seen that students, like for example, if you have 19 subjects which you have to prepare, there are for sure few subjects which you are 100% confident in. Do not give a lot of time in reading those subjects again and again. For example, if I talk about anatomy, biochemistry, physiology, if you feel that these topics are done for you, please do not keep on reading the same topics. So that is something which you have to avoid, and that is repetition. Repetition of same subject again and again. Do not keep on reading one subject again and again, even if you know the subject very well. What you have to do, just try to give a lot of grand test or lot of subject wise test so that you will know that how much you are prepared for that particular subject. Okay? So very, very important point will be avoid the repetition. If something is weak, try to do that. If something is strong, avoid repeating that subject. Second is give a lot of grand test and give a lot of subject wise test. Now there are many students who keep on revising or keep on revising the same thing again and again, again and again. Like they use same subjects, books, or you know, they try to get a lot of material. For example, if somebody says that coaching has a good good study material, so they will go and buy that particular material from that coaching. Somebody says that online platform is good, they will go and get themselves enrolled in that particular coaching. I would recommend, please do not keep on accumulating the burden on you. Focus on one thing. If you are focusing, or if you are with an academy, try to use the an academy notes. Try to use the notes which an academy educators are trying to tell. Do not keep on accumulating the stuff from everywhere, because ultimately this will give you a lot of confusion. Next is, you have to make a proper strategy. Like if you have to make a strategy for the next 20 days, I would recommend that start doing the MCQs. That's it. You have to target yourself according to the weightage or the number of questions you get from one particular subject. So I will tell you how much you get from each subject. We have a topic list made here, but give the time accordingly. So I will tell you how to make a 20-day strategy right now. Now we will make a timetable of your own. Do not share the timetable with others. I've seen that there are a lot of people who ask their friends, yaar, tune jo timetable banaya hai, mujhe bhi de de. Or whatever you have made, just try to give me also, so that I will follow the same timetable. But please remember, others' timetable will not suit you. Or it is not always necessary that if somebody is reading in the morning more, you will also have reading more in the morning. It depends upon person to person. Somebody has a habit of reading late night, but others must have a habit of reading in the morning. So please make your own timetables. Try to make short timetables, like you can make weekly timetables. if we start from Monday, you can make the time according to hour, that in the morning 2 hours I will be watching the live sessions, or I will be reading my own notes which I have made, or my own books which I am already using for these particular subjects. Try to keep 2 hours every day for MCQ solving. And lastly, please keep few hours, maybe 1 or 2 hours, for watching the live videos. At an academy, all the educators save live special classes, which you can easily unlock using this referral code. If you use this referral code, you can easily unlock the live classes of all the educators. So try to spend at least 1 day so that you remain updated of what is going on. Any change in the syllabus, any new topic which has a good possibility of being asked. So please be updated by watching regular sessions. Next is integration. Now nowadays we are seeing that you get more and more of integrated question even in FMG. Integrated means they will give you a few clinical history, a few images associated, and they will ask you the questions. Either they will ask you about diagnosis or they will ask you about treatment. So try to practice a lot of integrated questions. This will actually help you a lot in understanding or in solving. Now at an academy, I do take a lot of integrated MCQ sessions, and I'm sure that other educators are also taking the integrated sessions for their exams. Now subject wise distribution, please remember that the paraclinical, preclinical has almost 100 questions, while clinical has 200 questions. And this is the summary of subject wise questions. So I request all of you to please go through it. From the subjects in which you get more questions, try to spend more time. And the subjects which is giving you or which are giving you less questions, try to spend less time. That should be your strategy for this month. Now I will share you a 20-day strategy from now onwards, how you should revise from whatever you have prepared. Now I would request all of you to start doing with the final year subjects or the pre-final year subjects like surgery, OB-GYN and PSM. Try to finish these three subjects in the next 5 days. Along with the MCQs, and try to watch all the classes at least once or twice every day for updation. The next target should be completing physiology, pathology and pharmacology. You can take or you can give next 5 to 10 days for this as well. So 5 to 10 days can be given for this as well. Now you will be wondering that ma'am, you have not written you have not written medicine and you have not written pediatrics here. Please remember, when you cover these subjects, obviously little bit of medicine and pediatrics will be completed. It is not something which is left out. And then please focus on short subjects which can take another 2 to 5 days for you to finish. So your target should be to finish all the subjects at least 5 days before the exam, and for the last 5 days you will keep only for doing the MCQs or giving the grand test. Sources, as I always told you, that always keep one source. Do not keep on going from one coaching to another coaching. I would request all of you to follow an academy. You have a lot of questions on an academy. You can go for the live and the recorded classes. We also have an academy notes, and we have free special classes every day. We have free special classes every day which are conducted, and you can easily unlock it using the code CHESHTA10. Ultimately, I always say that success is directly proportional to number of revision. Whatever you have read, make sure that at least twice or thrice you should or you must revise those topic. At least twice or thrice you must revise those topic. That is very, very important for you. And lastly, multiple choice questions. Previous 3 to 5 year MCQs. Previous year papers. Previous year papers, at least previous 3 to 5 years, is very important for your revision. So try to do a lot of MCQs along with the PYQs. And please remember, for the next 20 days, say no to social media. No Facebooking, nothing, because everything can distract you. Obviously, not all are in this competitive phase right now. So obviously your friends, your neighbors, they must be putting a lot of interesting images, they must be spending a lot of time on all these medias, but for you it is a very high time to read. So do not waste a lot of time, because you can keep your mind like that only 5 minutes, but you never stop scrolling after 5 minutes, it keep on occurring. You can even watch something for 5 minutes, but then it keep on coming, and you can waste many hours on this social media platform. So please avoid doing that, at least for the next 20-25 days, because very limited time is left. So I think everybody have understood. Lastly, I just want you to help that Unacademy gives you a lot of free classes, and we have paid subscriptions like Plus, and we have Iconic, which give you an access to both Unacademy and PrepLadder. These special classes can be unlocked using the referral code CHESHTA10, and they are very, very similar to that of live Plus classes. We have a highly effective question bank of 25,000 plus questions. You can easily access it using the referral code CHESHTA10. These are some of our live learners who have performed very well in NEET PG. Also in FMG, we had 100% strike rate last exam. We have a feature which is known as Raise a Hand. There are many, many free grant tests and scholarship tests awaited for this month. You can join them. The batch for FMG 2022 is also starting today. Some of the free test series for this month is scheduled here, so please be a part of it. Batches for NEET PG and subject-wise batch for integrated next exam is also scheduled for today. And if you want to get subscription, these are the offers going on. 24-month subscription give you 4-month free. 12-month will give you 2-month free. And 6-month will give you 1-month free. So I request all of you to please start subscribing Unacademy using the referral code CHESHTA10. Using the referral code.